Okay, I think we are live. Good evening, everybody. So I was just getting set up there and talking to... I just need to do one thing, guys, real quick. I do apologize. There we go. So exciting this evening. We are attempting a simulcast to live, so live streaming to, obviously, here on Twitch, also to Facebook and to YouTube. So we're giving it a go. I was doing the setup today, and anybody that knows me, I mean, I can work a computer, but I definitely, that is way beyond my skills of getting simulcast going and streaming to multiple social media platforms. But with Jason Sorensen behind the scenes, he was guiding me through earlier on today, and hopefully we should be live across all those channels right now. So YouTube, Facebook, and here on Lord of the Dance TV on Twitch. And we'll take you through most of the lesson on, obviously on Twitch will be the full lesson, but on Facebook and YouTube, we'll take you through as much as we can, and then you'll have to come over here and join us on Twitch. So we'll just give it a couple of minutes. I think announcements just went out that we've started the lesson. And see if a few more people are going to join us. Yes, I am here from my living room. Where else would I be whilst we're on lockdown? I can't be anywhere else, can I? So I've mixed it up between my kitchen, I had the last lesson here in my living room, and maybe I will get into the garden one of these days and do a lesson from there. It does get a little bit warm in here. So feel free to say hello. Let me know if you're in the chat room. I want to check that this is working okay. Before we get started, I seen on our social media the promo clip for tonight's lesson. We were showing the clips of us doing the victory dance last lesson, and Jason had done a cool edit with that on the actual victory dance, and it was cutting in and out of us learning it here in my living room and then the actual dance itself. So as you can see, we weren't cutting any corners, we were learning the proper dance. And I want to teach you that brush step. Cut 16 just followed. Hey there. You're very welcome. Hopefully get some new followers tonight because we're out on Facebook and YouTube. So hopefully we get some new followers coming over to visit us here on Twitch. So yeah, feel free to say hello. Let us know that you're in the chat room. I do want to know how it's going. Jason's on the phone here with me as well. Facebook isn't up for some reason. Twitch and YouTube are up. Fantastic. Okay, so yes, Jesus saying, unfortunately I can't see the chat room, unfortunately. I don't know. We'll see if Jason wants me to do anything about that in a few minutes. So sorry I can't see your comments. I thought it was a bit quiet. I thought everyone was a bit shy tonight. But yeah, we've not managed to get over onto Facebook. I told you it's tricky stuff. This is very, very technical stuff. And maybe the fact that I was the one that was setting it up on my laptop could have been something to do with it. I'm not quite sure. I did go step by step with Jason for a couple of hours today. We all know Jason. He's our, what would we call Jason, social media / tech expert. Behind the scenes, he was helping me set it up. We thought we got it right, but it is extremely complex to be able to simulcast from this channel, you know, from Twitch across all them other channels, Lord of the Dance and YouTube. So I believe we are on YouTube. We just haven't got onto Facebook. Hopefully Jason will be able to get my chat room sorted. Sarah Wakefield just subscribed. Hey, Sarah. So I'm seeing who subscribes. I just can't see the chat room. Anyway, not to worry. I'll wait to be guided off Jason, whether he's going to, if he needs me to do anything to get that chat room, because it would be nice for me to, I mean, it's interactive TV, so it would be nice to get that chat room up. But I'll let Jason work behind the scenes there for a couple of minutes. And what I'll do is we'll just get on with some dancing. We'll just go over those treble rhythms again from yesterday. Let me give you a breakdown of what we're going to do in this class. Yes, 2 days ago in our last lesson, we worked on the victory dance. So I want to recap on that in case any of you have gone away and practiced it. Obviously, we'll have some new people, new subscribers, new people watching that didn't see the last class. So if you want to join in for that bit, or if you don't, that's up to you. But we'll slow it down again to an extent, but then we also want to quicken it up for the guys that did it last time. But in the meantime, right here, when I start, we're going to do some treble sequences that I want to use later on. We're pulling little pieces from the show whilst also learning tricky Irish dance moves. So one piece we're going to do today is a little piece from In the Dangerous Game show. There's a piece at the end, and it's on the screen or sometimes a hologram, and it's Michael Flatley. Three of Michael Flatley all dancing together, and it's some of the rhythm sequences from that. I'm just checking my message from Jason. Sorry, guys. Okay. Okay, I'm just going to fiddle around here for 1 second, guys. Sorry, bear with me, because I'm going to open up so I can see the chat rooms, because it is essential for me to talk to you at the end of the day, isn't it? Oops. I'm just going to open up the chat rooms here so I can see what is going on. Just bear with me a moment. I'm just going to go into the Twitch, open a different page with the Twitch channel, and then hopefully I'll be able to see the chat room and we can interact through the lesson. All right, essential. I need to hear what you guys are saying. Hope everyone's doing okay in isolation. What day are we on? I've lost count of the days. They all seem the same, don't they? When you're homebound. Most of us are homebound. Okay, almost there. Sorry, my computer's going a little bit slow. There's a lot going on. Okay, I'm almost there, almost there, almost there. Oh, nothing easy, is it? It's loading. Oh. Welcome to the room. I'm almost in, guys. Almost in. I think. Give me 1 more second. Oh, we're going to have a great chat once I get in, aren't we? Welcome to the chat room. I think I might be in. Hi. Ah, oh, nothing easy, is it? Oh, I need to mute.
All right.
It's loading. Oh, room. I'm almost in, guys. Almost in. Okay. Think. I just need to find. Give me 1 more second. Oh, we're going to have a great chat once I get in, aren't we? Welcome to the chat room. I think I might be in. Hi. Oh, nothing easy, is it? Oh, I need to mute the chat. Okay. Right. That should be me sorted. Let me see. Thank you for bearing with me, guys. As I said. Right. Okay. Chat room. I think I'm in. Lisa, hello. I hope you're doing well. This might be a while ago now because that obviously took me a while. Hello, Nicole in Luxembourg. I'm good, thank you. Mr. Brightside, good morning from Australia, Melbourne. Wow, how are you doing? Good morning. Yes, because you're ahead of us, aren't you? Welsh lad, yes. Oh, he's talking to Lisa. Matthias is here. Hello, Attilies. Tough name to say. Test, test, 1, 2 from Carl. Yes, hope you can hear me okay. Hello, guys. You're all telling me good evening again because it's probably taking me so long. Am I live in the chat room? Is this going to plan? Hi, Sarah. I hope so. As I said, this is my worst nightmare. Where's Winston? He's out on a walk because he had wild hour early this evening. He was literally the most wild puppy you've ever seen about half an hour ago. So if he was in the house, he was running so fast, he was running into walls. I'm not even joking. Okay, great. A new follower. Fantastic. Out of place. Okay, so Lisa, please stay safe. It's a new situation for me staying in quarantine. Yeah. Great. Talk about the quarantine. I know. We see and hear you, James. Great. Lovely, lovely, lovely. Okay. Winston is an English Springer Spaniel with his floppy ears. So he's 13 weeks old. English Bulldog. Not an English Bulldog, an English Springer Spaniel. So let me see. Oh, it's all going on here. I've even got my mum texting. All right, I'm on. Okay. I think we're ready to go. Are we all ready to go, guys? Jason, if you're listening, I didn't get to the chat room on YouTube. If you're watching on YouTube, I'm too much for me to go into that chat room as well while streaming on Twitch. I'm sorry, guys. I'm a dancer. I'm not really joking. If you're on YouTube, why don't you come over and join us here on Twitch? Okay. Just come over because you don't, basically twitch.tv/ Lord of the Dance. Okay? Easy. Or is it Twitch/ Lord of the Dance TV? See, I don't even get that right. But come over if you're on YouTube and you can join in the chat room here. Or if you want to keep watching YouTube, don't use the chat room. That is fine as well. Okay? Bless him from Carl. I know. I'm under pressure here. Let's dance. Right. Ready, guys. I think there's a slight delay in that. Okay. So what we're going to do is just go through those travel sequences again that we did last lesson. Okay, just getting the feet warmed up. So we're just going. Okay, so remember it's just 1, 2, 1, 2, okay? 1, 2, 1, 2, all right? Remember last lesson I spoke about using this upper leg? So you can go like this, but then if you travel from the upper leg, you really get that nice twist going, all right? And the Flatley kind of style, okay? Are we all with me? What about a workout, Mary, together? So girls and boys can do anything? I'm not sure about that one, what you mean, but Mary and I work out all the time together. He's a Lord of the Dance, not Lord of the IT department. Hell yes, amen to that. I know, under pressure, opening different stuff and chat rooms. I'm only joking. I think we're there now. Okay, so yes, going over them travels. I was just checking you all with me. Okay, so what we're actually going to do here in this opening scene, I'm just going to throw different rhythms at you throughout the class. So to begin with, okay, this is the sequence we're going to learn. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, heel toe. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and toe. Is that 5? It is 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then we add in the toe at the bottom, okay? So let's do them 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4, down with your tip, ball of your foot, heel, toe. Alright? Are we getting this leg loose? Just remember, shake it in the air to get used to it, and then really you just have to connect the tip to the floor. That's it, okay? Go back to mid-air, back to the floor. That's it, and then you do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So the 5 is a stop dead, all right? Are you with me?
I hope you're up and about. I've been going all over the steps, Carl. Good. Heads up, James is doing an epic job. This is brand new tech we're trying out. Yeah, thanks, Jason. It is, yeah. Really cool, though, isn't it, that we're able to do this? I know we haven't been able to get to Facebook, but when I was going through this with Jason today, it is actually amazing that we haven't mastered it yet, but it's possible for us to do this. Okay, brilliant. Okay, so go back to that. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, down. 1, 2, 3, 4, down. All right, so you see how it's like 5 tips, but the last one is different. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and down. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is hard to say. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Heel then, you just drop that heel, heel, toe. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, heel, toe. That's it. Now I've got my tongue around it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, heel, toe. All right? When that's sped up. All right? So it's a nice move like that. See how it's nice and quick? Okay? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and down. Are we getting that? So the reason I'm teaching you that is because it's Michael Flatley-esque, all right? Nice twisting legs. But also, it teaches you to loosen, what I'm saying, activate this upper leg instead of too stiff like this. You know, you wouldn't be able to do it. It's got to loosen the leg. Okay, nice twist. All right, and then you can see how Michael Flatley would get the arms in, or anyone in all the dance, and then you can cross it over, all right? Then you can start it out here, finish it. All right, and add in a bit of style. There we go, guys. Okay. Let's catch up with Lisa, I'm sorry to hear that. Your mum got infected. Very sorry to hear that. I'm just catching up on the comments. Yeah, we wish her a speedy recovery. We can go live on Facebook as well, but the broadcast will have to be routed through my computer. Okay, so from there, let's just go back to our trebles. One thing we're going to learn at the end, remember I said we're going to learn a part from the Michael Flatley video at the end. Someone was asking me in the last lesson about the three lords. This is sometimes called three lords, it's three Michael Flatleys. And the step we're going to be learning later is this. Okay? Now, what he does is, we're actually going to start this on the left foot. Because he finishes off with a back click, and the three videos of him, or sometimes holograms, he does a back click, which is one of these, all right? And they form into one Michael Flatley, and he finishes the sequence off. Now, how that goes is this, he goes, okay, so We'll get to that piece later, all this. All right, looks harder than it is, don't worry. We can all do it. We'll all get there, we get through everything else. But the piece at the end, it's just down, couple, hop back, and then into that back click. So what I'm gonna do now is, while we're warming up, is just practice that simple treble back. So down, tip, tip, hop back, okay? Remember, easy, but the hop will become smaller, but it's essential. Tip, tip, hop back, okay? Can you see my feet okay, everyone? All right, down, tip, tip, hop back, all right? That hop is essential. So this is just what I wanna practice first, because this is used so much in so many sequences. All right, let me just see how everyone's doing for anyone. Can you do it again, please? Yes, are you on about the Michael Flatley three Lord one? I will certainly, anything for you, Lisa. Kind of reminds me of those snare drum beats. Marches, yeah. It is, exactly, good shout. A new follower, great. Yes, hoping I'll be a distraction here for a while. So let's go with that. You want to see me do that rhythm again? Just before I do it, I'll show you that this end piece is what we're working on, so you can have a go. All right, so it goes, I'll face away from you. So down with the back foot, then we do treble. All right, so down, tip, tip, hop, back. All right, that's just a treble, hop, back, okay? All right, sometimes we do rolling treble backs. Perfect. So that's at the end of this sequence that we're going to be learning a little bit later on. First, we're going to recap on victory dance. Then we're going to learn a new step in victory dance. Then we're going to go on to learning this step. Okay. Right. So. All right. Let's try that back. Adding in that back click now. Down, treble, hop back. Step forward. Lift up the back leg. And click the heels together. So the same as we do our front clicks, this is a back click now. What is the fast treble step? You fast treble plus it gives you the sorry, I'm just catching up on the comments, guys. A couple of song lyrics going on in there. Plus, it gives you time, guys, to change to Planet Island. Yeah, this is when the video of Michael is on, and it gives us time to get ready for that final dance. Okay, I'm going to dance it one more time. Oh, the fastest step I can do. I don't know, Lisa. I guess some of the Michael Flatley rhythms. In the Feet of Flame. They're quite fast. Remember this from the Feet of Flame solo? Remember all that stuff? That's all quite fast. You got to be on the ball for that stuff. God, I'm going to get to this Michael Flatley step in a minute. I don't know what's the fastest there. That one I just did first there is pretty fast. You love that solo, I know, so do I, amazing. So the Michael Flatley step, three Lord steps. It goes, boom, boom. That's it, okay? We're going to be learning that later on. You are going to be dancing that step in your living room or your garden or your kitchen or your bedroom or wherever you are. I promise you, you'll be doing that step. Promise. It's not as hard as it looks. It's rhythm that we've already done. If you haven't been here before on Lord of the Dance TV, interactive lessons, it's rhythm you can learn today, okay? All it has to be done is broken down,
by me. Obviously, I'm a great teacher, so I'll teach anybody anything. Just kidding. All right, back to the victory dance. Just answer this question, sorry. Just, you know, we have to watch that. We're not watch the video, but we listen to that video backstage every single night. So you just got to learn the rhythm patterns. So I obviously know that rhythm, diddly back, but it's just how it was put together. So I'm backstage and we can hear dum, diddly back, diddly back, diddly back, stamp, bun, diddly back, diddly back, diddly back, stamp, bun, diddly back, diddly back, stamp, dribble on the back, click, click, and down. All right, so then you send the message to the legs. And then you can do it. So that's how a dancer works, really. If you've been dancing a long time, you can hear the rhythm patterns, and then you get the legs to perform it. So yeah, no problem. Of course, I'll answer. Try and answer all your questions, guys. Unless it goes too fast for me. See how fast I am beating. I know. Okay, let's go to the finale steps. So I have a quick recap of them. And then I want to teach you that brush step. Do you remember I told you it was this one? It went twist, 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 twist. Okay? And then we're up to the last half of that dance. Okay? So, first of all, we'll go back and recap. I need to go for an eye test. My eyes are going. Another new follower. Brilliant. You're very welcome. Would you say that a tap dancer and a drummer think alike to some extent? Absolutely. Absolutely. They're using their hands, we're using the legs, but it's pretty much the same beat, the same beat to the music, rhythm patterns, of course. Which steps of the show were the hardest to learn of your solos? Michael Flatley's steps. Some of them in the duel are very difficult. Obviously, there's only a few of us have done the Feet of Flame solo. I know it's not in the current Lord of Dance show, but that was very difficult. Like some of the steps I just demonstrated. But in Lord of the Dance itself, there were some parts of Cry of the Celt, some parts of the Jewel that were very difficult. And then lots of parts, you would see them pop up in other solos. So once you mastered them, you had them. Ruben Ruse subscribed with Twitch Prime. Lovely. Brilliant. Love this. Hopefully seeing you in South Africa. I do hope so. Yes. Well, I do actually know that we will be back in South Africa. I'm just not sure of when. Okay. But we definitely will see you there. Welcome to Deal. Okay. Yep. And have you taught your students any of the Lord of the Dance steps? Do you know what? Believe it or not, not that many. You would think that would be the first thing I'd be teaching, but with any competitive student, there's so much to learn. There's so many intricate rhythm patterns, and you're constantly trying to drill them to get that posture, their arms by their side, which is not what we then go on to do in show dancing. But in the competitive world, it's all about being tall, arms by your side, top half not moving. So there's so much to drill on that, and then so much technical stuff below that we don't do a lot of. You know, it's not like I'm teaching Lord of Dance steps every night, but we did actually start to recently. A lot of our lessons are online now with the pandemic that's going on. Well, all of them are, because we can't have dance lessons anymore. So that's given us a good excuse to start doing some other stuff. And we did some displays recently where I did like a simplified version of the Lord of the Dance steps, just so to make it a bit quicker to learn. But you guys aren't getting the simplified version. You're getting the tough version here on Twitch. There's no cutting corners. We're breaking it down. And yeah, that's where we're at. Did you ever fall during a show, or is this something that didn't happen to you? Do you know, I was only thinking of this the other day, Lisa, that in 17 years in the show, I've only fell over once in the back line and once as lead. And it wasn't fun as lead, trust me, because it was right in the middle of my Lord of the Dance solo. but it happens so quick. As a dancer, you're just so, you're not trained for falling, but you're just so, your legs are so used to doing every single tap and moving in a certain way, that when I went to the floor, I was back up in about 1/1,000,000th of a second, because my legs were just ready for the next piece. So luckily, I was able to bounce back up. You know, it wasn't like a serious fall, but my pride was a little bit damaged. And one other time was in the original, do you remember the Shimsa dance where we all used to wear multicolored costumes? I think I had a pink one on, which made it even worse. And we had a step in that went like this. They went like this. We're all stood with our hands out, so it would be a girl either side of me. Went girl, boy, girl, boy, girl, boy. And the guys faced out the circle, and the girls faced in. And then we switched over, and the guys faced in, the girls faced out. And we did the step look like this: up and back, come back to 3-4. Up and back, come back to 3-4. Okay. So I'm right at the front of the circle. The audience is here, thousands of people, and I went up, and my back leg went. And I went straight on my backside. And then obviously in the next sequence, the girls are supposed to change place with the guys. So I then had like girls skipping over my body while I'm rolling around the floor, trying to get back up. Oh, I hadn't been in the show a long time then either. So that was an absolute disaster. Hello, Mia. Is this Mia? Mia from the Keegan Academy, or just another Mia? Hello, regardless. I saw the rehearsal video from Taiwan, I think, and you're sliding a bit, but it was a rehearsal. I don't know, maybe I was slipping and sliding. Sometimes you don't rehearse on the best of floors. I remember last time you were in Denmark doing Planet Island, there were a blonde girl who fell. But in what feels like nanoseconds, exactly, I know. She rised and got back into the steps. I remember I was like, God, is she okay? How can she just continue? It was amazing. I know, that's what I mean. It's like, I always talk about autopilot. But it's like, when that autopilot cuts out, you know, it's like, your body's in shock. It instantly is just like, whoosh. So same thing, if you fall over, it's like your body is just so quick to get back to them, back onto that autopilot, to get back to where the step is up to. We might be live on Facebook. Wow. Now I can see that MF kept this troop in top shape when making dangerous games. Yes. Oof. I fell on stage when I had a live performance in 2009 and I broke a rib. Not good. So lucky you have a big pain. Yeah, luckily I wasn't hurt, but like I said, the pride, it's not nice to go back out there after you fell on your backside, believe me. I'm a huge fan of Lord of Dance for the last 20 years from Mexico. Oh, wow. Hello to everyone in Mexico. We were just back from Mexico. Did we see you there? It was amazing. We love Mexico. Okay, so on with them finale steps. What we're going to do is learn the brush step first. While we're a bit fresher. Okay, let me see where we're up to. Let's learn the brush step and then we'll go back and recap on all them finale steps. Oh, wow. Someone stabbed themselves, Alice Cooper, in the leg. Oh, dear. Do you miss some of the old music? And steps like Shimsa. I do not miss Shimsa. Let me just clarify that right here, right now. Shimsa was about, I think it was only about 3.5-4 minutes long. It felt like 45 minutes. Okay? Here's a challenge for you all. Here is a challenge. Go on to, I think the original Lord of the Dance music is on, probably on Spotify, Apple Music, whatever you use. I'll show you the skip to threes now in case anybody can't do skip to threes. Okay? And not even the pink shirt. Definitely not the pink shirt. I'll tell you another funny one about that now. Put that music on and do skip to threes, okay, which I'm going to show you how to do now, for that whole track. And then next lesson, tell me how your calves here and your arches felt. And you can do, if you don't have proper dance pumps, do it in your socks, all right? Because it's practically the same thing. And just tell me, she misses 4 minutes and 30 seconds. All right, there you go. Well, it feels like 44 minutes and 30 seconds. I can understand it being tough, but I have to say, she misses was almost fit. It is. It was a good party dance, but I'm just having a moan. You know, even, here's one for you. Even at the end, we've been dancing on our toes, pretty much on your toes, or the you know, high up on the balls of your feet, for 4 minutes and, what was it, 30 seconds. Well, on about 4 minutes, we go into a circle, and then the girls jump back onto our arms. So just when your calves are thinking they can't take any more, you're like this going around, and then the girls go on it, right? Oh, the pain, I can still relive the pain now. Right, here's the skip 2-3s I'm all about. So you go 1-2-3, skip 1-2-3, skip 1-2-3, skip 1-2-3. They always say, like you're in the playground, skip and skip. You're going to skip 2-3s. Put on the original Shimsa music, find it, dance it all the way through. On the parts where the music changes, just do toe raises. Because we used to have lift girls up and do other things. And let me know how you find that. All right, everyone, that's your challenge. I'm going to look for images of you in that shirt now. You really don't have to do that. Pink suits you good. It'd look awesome in pink. Well, thank you very much. But I don't think I did. Yes, never thought of that. It seems too easy. Yeah. And one other quick one about that pink costume. I was only in the show literally about a month, and we did some shows here in Manchester, a week in Manchester. And being very naive and young, I stupidly now, naively, announced in the lads' dressing room. I said, lads, I'm in my hometown. Friends and family are going to be out there. Is there any chance somebody would just... There was like about... Two or three guys would wear pink, two or three guys would wear green, two or three guys would wear orange. So I just said, would anybody just mind picking, switching with me? And I don't have to wear the pink costume because, you know, my mates from school are coming, my old mates used to play football with. And you don't want them to remember you dressed head to toe in pink. You want them to remember how cool everything else was in the show. So, yeah, that didn't go to plan. Obviously, lads being lads. They hid every other costume at the time, left only my pink one on the rail. And then instead of two or three guys being in pink, I was the only guy in pink in the dance. So I stood out even more, head to toe in pink. And lesson learned, don't ask silly questions to any of the lads or you will get the mickey taken out of you, like happened to me. So I missed the old gypsy melody. Catching up with some comments here. Yeah, they did remember me in pink, yeah. I know. They still talk. The lads, some of the older lads still talk about that now. Yeah, they got me good. The current one is amazing, but I missed the three stages. Oh, you're talking about the gypsy music. Yes, it was good. So cruel. I know it was cruel, wasn't it? I was only turning 17 that month. As a young, innocent lad asking a simple request. When in my hometown, they couldn't do it. Does Mr. Flatley know that story? I don't think he does. I might tell him next time I see him. Big D loved pink as well. Big D was probably one of the ones that set me up. Okay, finale steps. Brush step. Okay, so it goes. Hop, shuffle, hand stamp. All right. Okay, so. Down, treble. Hop onto it and stamp. All right, watch that again. So we go, and treble, and weight on it, stamp, okay? And so, down, treble, and stamp. So you really need to quicken that up. So it's like, I'll do it on the left foot, so you can mirror me, your right foot. And treble and stamp, 2, 3, 4. Down, treble and stamp, 2, 3, 4. Down, treble and stamp. Okay, now, so with your right leg, I'm going to do it on my left so you can mirror me. You go brush. So the same way you do a treble, a nice stiff leg, and brush with your tip. Brush, brush, brush. Okay?
So watch that again. Brush, brush, brush. So it goes down, triple and stamp. Run, two, three, four. Okay? Finishing with a toe. So hop, triple and stamp. One, two, three, four, toe. All right? They're all brushes. That's why it's called the brush step. Yes, you guessed it. Down, treble, and stamp. Now, with your right foot, one, two, three, four. So just going back the same way. Finish with a toe. On that toe, now stand back on it, and you do a cut at the same time, and finish with a front toe. This sounds very tricky, but we'll get there. All right, so you're gonna mirror me. So with your right foot, down, so sorry, with your left foot at the back, down, right treble, treble, and stamp. Now, brushes. Brush forward, brush back, brush forward, brush back, toe, up toe. All right, so watch that again. Toe at the back. I'll do it this way so you can see. So this is with your right leg, my right leg here. Toe, and then stand back on it, up toe. So practice that move, toe, up toe. So toe it here, and then stand on it. Toe, up toe. Toe, up toe. Are we getting it? Talk to me, are we getting it? Oh, what's going on? What's going on? Are we dancing? I hope so. Big D, oh, only. Have you thought of bringing Celtic Tiger back? Possibly, we think of everything, every day. They really can't discuss. Plus, that would be up to Michael. Oh, you mean we can't discuss? Yes, yes, yes. Can you dance the girl steps like in Breakout? I'm curious for ages how it would look if a guy danced those steps. I will show them to you, probably next lesson if that's all right. Because I was actually thinking earlier on, another follower, fantastic. I was thinking of that earlier on because I think, I know Sarah was asking me for that last time. Did we maybe start on it a little bit? But let's just make a whole lesson out of that next time. So let's get this victory done because I don't want to hop too many. I've got semi-OCD and I hate if we do little bits of stuff. We're all over the place. But let's do that next lesson. No problem at all. Getting it, James. Good man, Carl. Please do. Yes, no problem. One of the hand parts we do in a brush is getting the brush instead of the ball of the foot. Yes, it's like the tip. Is that what you're saying? One of the hard parts we do in the brush is getting the brush. Yeah, it's, you don't, yeah, it's not, it's kind of the tip, you are right, yeah. I keep hitting the tap when trying to brush. So, yeah, it's just kind of like that part of your shoe, right? You don't want to go too heavy, it's just, like it's really quick, but the key here is to keep this part of the leg strong. I did show you some breakout steps. Well, no problem. We'll go back and do it again properly. I feel you on the OCD, Asperger's, so I understand. Yeah, it is. Yeah, I mean, I'm not too bad, but I do like to finish something when I start it. Right, so this step again. Come on, stay with me. You're going to mirror me. So you're on your right leg. I'll do it on my left. So you can just, I can be your mirror. Two, three, four. And treble and stamp. Are we all getting that? Two, three, four. And treble and stamp. Now we brush. One, two, three, four, toe. Now we're gonna go like into a cut. So hop back on that toe, up toe. Okay? So all together, this is gonna be. Okay? Two, three, four. Da, 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 da. One, two, three, four, five. Now up and toe, up toe. Good. I'll do it this way. Sorry, I forgot that click. I knew I was forgetting something. And jump on and stamp. One, two, three, four, toe. Now, click and toe. Oh, we hadn't got that far yet, that's fine. Two, three, four. And jump on and stamp. One, two, three, four, five. So from here, we lift it up. Back click. All right, from there again, and we back click. Up. Okay, watch you don't kick your feet too hard. If you're just clicking the heels together, you probably haven't got shoes on, but it's supposed to be a back click is what we call that, okay? Are we getting it?
Let me read the comments. That's okay, you're all, no comments, which means you're all dancing. I love it. Oh, have you ever recorded how many taps you can do a second? I haven't. Lots of people always ask me that, but I think you need a fancy machine because it's impossible to count. Can you stand on your toe in your hard shoes as the tip is not the same as the girls have? Yes, I can stand on my tiptoes. It's not really a move done by men or boys in competition. Not as much anyway. It's more, and I don't know why. It's quite impressive. I don't, but in Irish dance, it's not. But yes, I can. I'll show you. Just the shoes have to be nice and broken in. Okay. Well, that's me on my toes. I can even probably treble up here. Oh, that is sore on the toes. Can you stand on your toes? Yeah, sorry, you got that. With a back click, does it matter how high the leg goes? I've heard about kicking the butt a few times. In Irish dance, you need to kick your butt, as you say, whenever you can. So whenever it's possible to get the leg up to your backside or lift, that is what you should do. That is the man himself, Michael Flatley, messaging me. So I must get back to the boss. I'll be 1 second. I'll tell him we're on Twitch. 1 second. Okay. He's just checking in to see I'm doing okay. What a nice guy. Michael Flatley on the phone. Yeah, I know. Yeah, sorry guys. Had to greetings, telling me love him. I will, of course. I will. I'll tell him you're all... I told him I'd message him after this, so I'll tell him. Ask him to join. Tell him F. Of course I will. Of course I will. Yeah, he's just checking how I'm doing because he knows... Obviously, he's in isolation as well. Everybody frustrated, isn't it? We need to be so much to be doing in life, and we're all going through this terrible time. The heel of his shoe came off. You know about that? Yeah, I was on stage for that one as well. He had to run off and get another one. I was there that night. Yeah, I was on the front row to the left of Mike. As you look at the stage, I was to the right of Michael. So I actually didn't see much of the commotion because I was up at the front. But I could hear a little bit, so he had his microphone on. How do you avoid hitting your toe or middle of your foot when making the click? Turn your toes out so just your heels are clicking together. We'll go through that now in a moment. And Michael is doing very good. Very good. He's God. He's a God. I'll tell him that. He'll like to hear that. He is a God, isn't he? We wouldn't be here without him. Tom did perform in the video that you were talking about, Aero. Tom came forward ready to perform Michael's solo, and Michael got back literally to the second and took over and did his little solo in that piece. So you are right, Lisa. Good observation. Yes, that back click. So you're like this. So you lift up the foot, okay? So you're going to keep the feet turned out, though, because you want to connect there like that, okay? So best way to do this, same as we do our front clicks, is get two chairs, okay, hold on to the two chairs just to get used to connecting with your back clicks. You don't kick your feet too much and hurt them, okay? Right, so we're almost there with this step. Let's just keep going. Let's go one more time. 2, 3, 4. Down, trap, pull, and stamp. 1, 2, 3, 4. Toe, up and toe. Now, from that toe, we do a down, treble, and toe, cut toe. Again, the similar move there. All right? So from, let's go from the beginning. 2, 3, 4. Down, treble, and stamp. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, toe,
kick and toe. Now, down treble and toe, cut toe. Down treble and toe, up toe. All right? Can we put all that together, do you think, and dance that through?
Okay.
Yeah. All right, ready? Two, three, four. Down treble and snap. One, two, three, four, toe. Kick and toe. Down treble and toe, cup toe. Now we're up to the twist, which we've already done before in the last class. Twist, twist, twist. In, out, in. Now go on to the back foot. Down treble, hop back. That's what I was telling you at the start of the lesson. Step, toe, hop, round. So it goes step with the left, right, sorry, one, two, three, one, two, three, and triple hop back. So step with the left, toe with the right, hop with the left, step with the right. So keep going, down, triple hop back, step, toe, hop, round. All right, keep moving the foot, left foot, keep moving your feet, left, right, left shoulder back, down, triple hop back, step, toe, hop, round. And that will be facing the back then, ready to dance to the back. So if I dance this to you, as if you're my audience, I'm going to dance it on my right leg now, so don't mirror me. It will go from the beginning, two, three, four. And jump on a stamp, one, two, three, four, five. Hit the bum, da 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 da, toe, cup, toe. One, two, three, twist, twist, twist. Down, jump on, hop back, step, toe, hop, round. And then we dance to the back. Okay? I tried to sing a little bit of the tune there so you can hear it. I'll do it one more time. Let me check if you're still with me. Oh, there's no questions here. You're getting lost. Yeah, let's try it. Ready? Good, good, good. I hit my ankle so bad when you teach the front clicks in Berlin and got a bad bruise. We loved every second. I know you can. You're not the only one, Lisa. A lot of people kick themselves learning them clicks. It's a bit tricky, isn't it? Hi, James. Enjoying watching you. Love, Joe, Martha, Joseph, and Gabriel. Hey, that's my sister and nieces and nephew. How are you all doing? Good to have you on Twitch. Hope you're dancing along. My little nieces and nephew, fantastic. Fantastic at everything. Dancers, football, musicians, violin, piano, you name it. Acting, singing. They were in the choir when I went to Young Gifted and Green concert. So lots of kisses to you guys. Does victory have more toes and brushes in it than the numbers in the show? Than other numbers in the show, I think you mean. Than the other numbers in the show. Yeah, it definitely has. The brush step isn't used anywhere else. And what are you asking me here? Sorry, Michael Flatley on the phone. He says, no worries and good luck. Yeah, it probably does have more, yeah, of this kind of twist. And I don't think the brush is used anywhere else. I had a question on Facebook covering shoe size. I'm a US 14.5 to 15. It seems I can't buy larger sizes for now. I use dress shoes only for like a wedding. Gonna say thanks for these lessons. Yeah, well, maybe you could get a tap, a Capizio tap, attached to the bottom of those dress shoes, and then it's like a tap shoe. You know, it's just good to make the noise, make the tap. So yeah, that's good thinking with the dress shoe. How many times do you treble during the part to the back? I'll show you that now in one second. Do you mean the next section, Smooth Criminal? Is that what you mean? I'll show you that now in one second. They are a talented family, the O'Briens. Now, yes, they are very talented. And beautiful, amazing mix of talents there. Love an artistic family. I know, but great parents. My sister and her husband Barry, sister Jo. How do you feel when you get a message from MF? Do you get nervous? Like, I used to. I'm not saying I don't get nervous anymore because he's the, you know, he's an absolute living legend. But no, it's. Yeah, it's exciting to get to be in touch, always in touch with Michael, and because he's, most times you speak to him, he's got some kind of, he's kind of oozing with passion and energy. So he gets you going, he gets you energized and feeling passionate about whatever it is he's calling you to talk about.
Thank you very much. Before the rock twist, let's go for that. Question for YouTube. How long have you been with Team Lord? 17 years. June the 13th, I think, 2003. Wow, where the years go. So, what are we in now? 2020? So is that 17 years coming up in June? We'll have to have a big party. One of his last shows in South Africa. 17 years old, yeah. 17 years, sorry. Correct, Lisa. One of his last shows in South Africa. I think you meet Michael Flatley, yeah. He met with me after the show for an hour. Wow, really good. You were in the first grade back then. Lovely, thank you for making me feel old. You were four then, Mr. Brightside. Great, thanks guys. Lovely to hear it all, how young you were when I joined. Does it feel weird for you to refer to him as Michael Flatley when you chat with us? I guess you just call him Michael, or maybe a nickname. No, you see, you're trying to get a nickname out of me. No nickname, I just call him Michael. But yeah, Michael Flatley. I gave him his full title on here. As if I know you know who we're talking about. I'm sure Michael would do the job. But right, let's dance that step one more time all the way through. And I'm just going to teach you the next little bit to get us up to the end section. And then we're going to dance the whole of finale. And then onto that step, the three Lord step that I did at the beginning. Because I've promised you that we're going to get that. And we are. I'm going to stick to my word and we're all going to get it. So you better get up dancing it with me now, guys. This is your homework over the weekend to be able to imagine next time your friends come around when all this palaver's over and you'll be able to go bum, diddly dum, diddly dum, diddly dum, stamp, and diddly dum, diddly dum, diddly dum, stamp, and diddly dum, diddly dum, diddly dum, stamp, treble on the back, and back click, bum. And then you arrive with a cup of tea through the door. How cool would that be? Sign is a tattoo on my skin. How crazy. I know, Lisa. I know, that is crazy. Right, here we go. Let's do that step. You can mirror me. 2, 3, and. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Kick a toe, treble and a toe. Cut toe. Out, in, out, in. Down, double, hop back, step, toe, hop round. Okay? How do we do? Victory with a cup of tea. All right, I'll dance it this way now so you can dance behind, as if you're dancing behind me. 2, 3, 4, and let's slow it down a bit. I get too carried away. 2, 3, 4, down, treble and stamp. 1, 2, 3, 4, toe, up and toe, down, treble and toe, cut toe, out, in, out, in, down, treble, hop back, step, toe, hop round. One more time at that speed, okay? Let me just see what you're saying there. The image of being the one person Irish dancing. Oh my God. good man, Carl's got it. You're listening to Victory right now. Brilliant. One more time with that. 2, 3, and. Down, treble and stamp. 1, 2, 3, 4. Toe, up and toe. And treble and toe. Cut toe. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Down, treble, hop back. So left toe, hop, round, okay? Then the step we go to the back is just, and one, and jump, 2, 3. Then we jump back onto that right foot, and one, and jump, 2, 3. This is the same as the dance on step at the beginning. And one, and one, and one, 2, 3. And two, and two, and two, 2, 3. Okay? Don't worry too much about that. Okay, let's go back to them steps at the beginning. That we haven't done this class, we did them last class. I just want to recap for those of you that weren't here. It was the 6 treble backs with the spins. We're just going to dance it one time through and that's it. Ready? 5, 6, 7, and 1. One corner, two corner, and front. One corner, two corner, and front. And stamp it again. One corner, two corner, three front. One corner, two corner, three front. And toe step. Twist. That's quick. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. And again.
first step. Twist, 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 twist and twist. Dump and toe, hop round and one and one and one, two, three. Then we're up to the end steps, okay? Yes, I know that was pretty fast, but grab a drink of water, guys, if you've got one handy. Oh, victory dance in the living room. New follower from Facebook, James Kelly says, good man, Keegan. Kiva thinks you are doing exercise. That is one of my best friends, James Kelly, and his daughter Kiva, as groomsman at James's wedding a couple of years ago. Well, more than a couple of years ago now, is it? 2016? And I grew up dancing with James Kelly for the Lally School. We had some fun over the years growing up dancing together. So good to see you, James and Kiva. Thanks for watching. And hope to see you soon. Do dancers who prefer to use their left leg have to just adapt to use their right? Dancers who prefer to use their left. You always have to learn in competitive dance a sequence or a step on the right foot, and then you have to learn it on the left foot. So each dance is made up of around like three step sequences, and you've got to dance them right and left foot for that reason. So you don't just become dominant on one foot, like way stronger on the right, way stronger on the left. Anyone else imagine James in that pink shirt whilst teaching us the moves right now? Leave it out, come on. I had a rough enough time back then, I don't need reminding about it, I'm joking. Please can you shout out to my son Simon, who is learning this with you. Of course, hello Simon, thanks for joining in, I hope you're getting it. We're going to learn the Michael Flatley three lord step in about 40 seconds, so stand by for that. These front row seats are pretty great. And which is one of your favourite dark lords to dance with? I like them all because they all bring something different to the table. I danced with Tom Cunningham for years. He was an absolute animal. Crazy, 100% professional every single night. As is Zoltan Pap. You know, he's just in the character from start to finish. Now, of course, we've got Alistair Spencer, Declan Durning, other guys coming up learning it. So they all bring their own style to it, and they all make it like a real fight every night. So it's good fun, no matter who it is. But yeah, they keep me on my toes, because if they raise the level, I am the Lord of the Dance. I have to be, well, look better, even if I'm not better, but I've got to give it everything. All right. So the harder they push, the harder I have to push back. From Facebook, Declan Murphy. I bet having to isolate at home will be something you won't be used to. Hope you're okay. Declan Murphy, great friend of mine. Good to have you on, Declan, or watching on Facebook. Thank you. Yeah, it's not something I'm used to. I think this is the longest I've ever been in the house in my life, or the longest I've ever been in one place. But yeah, do you know what? It's actually nice to be, although it's not nice to be on lockdown, but kind of nice to be in the same place for once. But I hope you're keeping well, Declan. While the guys are doing this part, getting ready in the trap. Am I in the trap? I've just done the duel in this part, Carl, so I'm doing a quick change and then I come on and join them at the end of this dance. I think she'll never go away. Kislany Mankey says, have you had many injuries so far? Your Irish accent is so lovely. Well, I didn't even know I had an Irish accent. I've got a Mancunian Irish accent. No, I've not had many injuries. I had an injury last year from walking in a pothole in Brazil in a pair of flip-flops, and I rolled the torn ligaments in my ankle. Can you believe that? In all the shows that I do every single night of the year, and I roll my ankle in a pothole while sightseeing. So that wasn't fun. And so I've had a couple of silly injuries like that, but nothing too drastic, thank goodness. And Zolly is scary. Yes, he is. Have any of the Dark Lords made you feel legitimately intimidated while performing? There was a couple back when I was first started doing the role who were a lot older than me. And, you know, they were
it really was like a dance-off, because I guess maybe they were like, you know, getting towards the end of their careers, and they were probably trying to not teach me a lesson, but, you know, show who was boss. Like they'd been a lead dancer for years and years. You know, the stage was theirs, and there was definitely elements of that coming through, where I was this young kid coming on, trying to do 30 taps a second. There was definitely a bit of intimidation tactics going on there. Right, I better go on to this Michael Flatley step that we're going to do. Do you know what, Smooth Criminal, we'll be a bit pushed for time to get them end steps in. Of course, we'll do it next time, one of the other lessons. It's just a lot of treble sequences. They're not actually that fun. Maybe you would find them fun, I don't know. But we will, of course, do them another day. When you come down the stairs, it would be as good as being on stage with you. Chris Allen and Brennan McCarron were good as the Dark Lord. Yes, they were. Love sharing the stage with them. When you perform Stolen Kiss and the Bad Girl and Mary comes, I'm just reading your messages, guys. Did you ever lost your hand and she... I think you mean when I dipped Mary. No, I've never dropped anybody. Thank God I haven't dropped anybody as of yet. Size you up maybe. Right, let's do this step. Let's get back up, get some dancing for a couple of seconds. If you're joining us from Facebook and from YouTube, so obviously with these messages coming in from Facebook, we have managed to simulcast over to Facebook, which is great news, because this is the first night that we've done this. We're here all the time on Twitch, on Lord of the Dance TV, but tonight we've done the simulcast over to YouTube and Facebook. We weren't sure if it was going to work, because it's technical stuff. I had to set it up today with Jason's guidance, our tech and social media guy. I don't think it worked in the beginning, but I'm getting messages from friends of mine on Facebook now, so it must be working, which is great news. But we're going to learn this Michael Flatley move, and then if you want to continue watching for the last part of the show, you'll have to come over here and join us on Twitch, okay? Because we are a Twitch TV program, okay? Join us. twitch.tv/Lord of the Dance. I hope I've got that right, or Jason's going to kill me. Awesome to see the stream is spreading out and going to other platforms. It is, but mainly, predominantly, we're here on Twitch, okay? We've just done the simulcast tonight because it's cool to be able to do it and broaden the audience, let them all know that we're here doing interactive Irish dance lessons. I got it right. Goodness. How did it feel being the Lord for the first time? I believe it was in Durban. It was in Port Elizabeth, almost, back in 2005. The most nerve-wracking experience of my life. To jump through that curtain and be the only guy on stage doing Michael Flatley steps at 17. Yeah, I was pretty nervous, to say the least. Here's Michael Flatley steps. Are we ready? Now, I told you at the start we were all going to be able to do this. I'm not going to break my promise. So, start off, turn to the side here. Back foot, left foot goes down. Okay? So, you're just going down. Now, with this front foot, this is the next foot to connect with the floor. Okay? Now, it's going to go like this. And you do another hop, back. That's pretty much the move. But watch it now and it goes quick. Okay? So you're gonna go down with the back foot. This front foot is gonna go as quick as you can, as quick as you can shake it out there. And then you do the hop immediately after it. So watch that again. Watch that again. Okay? Put that together, down, and then just finish off with the back. All right, so the whole little move. There you go, okay? Down, diddly, back, okay? The fast treble sometimes, oh, I don't want to confuse you, but remember, it's not both of them together. It's getting that back foot down first, and then front foot, okay? All right, I'm going to mirror you. So I'm going to do it on this foot, your right leg, I'm doing it on the left foot, so it's this leg. So we go down with the left foot, lifting up the front foot, ready to fire it, diddly. Back, all right, you see how quick I came in with that hop? So down, treble, hop back. I'm trying to do my own slow motion version here that some of you asked for last time. I'm doing my own slow-mo. Down, one, two, hop
back. All right, I'm even in slow motion voice. Then when it's up to normal speed. All right, then. Let me see if there's any comments there, if you're getting that. You were six when I did my first lead show. Yeah, it's a lot of banter in the chat room tonight. Everyone's just ripping into me. So on the diddly back, the weight stays on the front foot at the end. Yes, that's what I was just going on to. So it's going to go down, diddly back. No, it's onto that back foot, whoever asked that question, because you're going to go straight into the next diddly back. All right, so you start with, so mirror me. So down with the left foot, diddly hop back. Now, diddly hop back, diddly hop back, stamp. All right, so you see how you don't need a down before each one because they just roll into each other. Down, diddly hop down, diddly hop down, diddly hop down, stamp. Or down, diddly hop back, diddly hop back, diddly hop back, stamp. Whichever way you want to say it. Okay, do you understand? Got it, Carl, great. Okay, one more time. Two, three, four. Down, diddly hop back, diddly hop back, diddly hop back, stamp. And then you go again. Down, diddly hop back. Then again. Okay, down, triple hop back, step. Click down, down. All right, that's the bit we're going to get to in a minute. Okay, actually, I forgot. Can we start this on the left leg? So I'm going to turn away. Start this whole sequence on the left leg, and it will make the end piece easier. Okay, so same as me now. Right foot to the back. So down, treble, hop back, treble, hop back, treble, hop back, stamp. Down, treble, hop back, treble, hop back. Treble, hop back, stamp. One more, down, treble, hop back, treble, hop back, treble, hop back, stamp. Obviously them treble backs are like diddly back, diddly back. Just doing it slow for you for now. Then from here, down, treble, hop back, step, lift up the back right foot, click, hop down. Okay, so that sequence at the end, down, treble, hop back, step, up and down. And again, two, three, four, down, treble, hop back, step, back, click, down. Right, so, that whole piece together, full speed is, we're starting with the left foot, aren't we? Let's do it on left foot. I'll do right foot so you can mirror me, okay? So on the same foot, two, ready? Two, three, this is the speed we're going. Let's see if we can do it. Ready? Five, six, seven, and. That's one. That's two. That's three. How did we do? All right, we've got one more time. See if we got it. Let's check some of these comments. Carl's got it. So many new subscribers. Yes, great, great, great. There's banter, there's me. Mr. Brightside loves the banter. One more time, guys. Ready? And then we'll be finishing our simulcast with Facebook and YouTube. But come over and join us for the end. We'll be just a couple of questions and a cool down to finish off. You did hear Winston. You are right. He's back. He's in the house. Ready? So mirror me. You're starting on the left foot in front with a down, all right? So you'll do a down with your right foot. All right, but I'm gonna do mirror. Ready? Two, three, and. Down, diddly back, diddly back, diddly back, step and. Step and, diddly back, diddly back, diddly back, step, da 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 bum bam. And there you go, all right? Remember, what a cool move when your friends come over and you come dancing out of the kitchen like that. Cool rhythm, Michael Flatley rhythm, Michael Flatley sequence, and it's not that difficult. I would let Winston in here, but I think he might wreck the place and the laptop would be gone. Winston has been walking long. Yes, he was in. He went for a walk with Mary. I think she had him in the field trying to tire him out. Okay, guys, I'm going to finish the simulcast with Facebook and YouTube. Thank you for joining us. Remember, guys, that we're watching on that or on those platforms,
come over and watch us on Twitch. There's going to be loads going on Twitch, on Lord of the Dance TV. It's probably starting from the end of next week sometime. Obviously, we'll keep Dancing Lessons going, but we are hoping to get busier and busier here on Lord of the Dance TV and keeping lots of content coming your way. So, for you guys, I'm going to finish the stream on Facebook and YouTube. And we will be on here for a few more minutes on Twitch. But thank you for joining us, and hopefully see you.